Hello everybody, Flamin' Shark back with another video, and today we're jumping into Season 2, Episode 6 of... And I'm really excited for this because we came back with a vengeance in the previous episode. It was fucking great. I loved everything that happened both on and off Earth. We had some, you know, the Martian stuff, the Sequid stuff finally kind of come into roost. That plot line that was set up, like I said, I believe in episode 5 of season 1, finally taking hold in episode 5 of season 2. But in a lot of ways, the most memorable thing that happened, despite all the very real danger that Invincible and Eve and a lot of the Guardians are dealing with off-world right now, I think the most notable thing that happened in the last episode was with the remaining Guardians. Rexplode, Duplicate, Shrinking Ray, they had a run-in with the Lizard League, and everyone makes fun of the Lizard League until they fucking murder you. And that's basically what happened in the last episode. Shit was wild. Kate got completely fucked. I don't even, like... Eventually, number one, like, the real... I don't know how to define it. I'm just gonna say number one, because I shouldn't say the real Kate, because that's not really how it works. But number one and a duplicated Kate just were smashed together, and their, like, stomachs smashed open, and, you know, it was fucked. It's Invincible. You guys have a decent idea, whether you've seen it or not. Obviously, you have if you're here. And Ray got eaten, basically. So... And they actually left that on a cliffhanger where King Lizard had a gun, had a pistol to the back of the head of Rexplode. I will say, Rex is almost certainly surviving this. I'd be shocked if they kill him in this episode. And the reason has nothing to do with, like, oh, Rex is like a character that I can't see dying. Far from it. It's the impact of this moment, right? Like, obviously... This is going to fuck up Eve and Invincible and everyone else that, you know, some of their own died while they were gone doing something else. But in the end, there's nothing they can really do about it. That's unfortunately just how it went down. But Rex is going to feel responsible on a different level because he was there. He's going to feel like, I could have done something better. I could have prevented this. And it's really, I think, going to drive his character development, whether positively or negatively, into the future. It's going to... be a driving force in his character moving forward. And that impact of Kate's death, that impact of Ray's death, will be shown through Rex, which is why Rex now needs to survive. He needs to either get bailed out or find a way to beat King Lizard and continue on. Because now I'm actually the most interested in Rex's character I've probably ever been in the show. I think this was really a defining episode for him. He kind of helped out, you know, he was kind of being the nicest he's probably ever been to Adam Eve, and then, you know, on top of that, we get everything that happened with Ray and Kate, and he lost a hand too, of course, which is another thing that usually, you know, you lose a limb, that probably means you're gonna survive, because it's another harrowing reminder of what happened. It's something that can haunt him, scar him, all that fun psychological fuckery that I hope we get with Rex, and I think we could see a really interesting character evolution for him, whether positively or negatively. It's going to be interesting, which is why I fully expect him to survive. Could we lose someone in the Martian portion of this? Like, I could understand them only wanting to kill. If we're going to lose people on both sides of this, of these missions, I guess you could say, I could understand in episode 5 doing just the ones involving Earth and the Lizard League, because you kind of want to let them breathe a little bit. And then you get even more, like, shocking death on the other side in episode 6. There's definitely characters on that mission that could die. I mean, really, the only ones that aren't going to die are Immortal, Eve, and Invincible. I think everyone else is at least... You can at least discuss, right? To varying levels of likelihood. But I think outside of Immortal, Eve, and... Mark, I don't think anyone else actually is, like, off the table completely. And Immortal, just because they're gonna fucking find a way to revive him if he dies. That's just kind of the thing at this point. I don't expect him to die. We also had the end credit scene with our boy Alan. Really cool that Alan's actually going to survive. And I was thinking about this episode a little bit, kind of leading up to getting on here to record the next one. And I was thinking about how it actually makes a lot of sense. It's very fucked up. It's very Viltrum to do. But it makes sense that Bro took Alan's life support off and bet on Alan, you know, making his way out of it so he'd be stronger than ever. Because that feels like a type of thing they would probably do on Viltrumite to weed out the weak and to, like, get the strongest people. Because we know, we've heard about how, like, the Viltrumites, you know, weeded out the weak of their species and part of why they're so ungodly powerful. And that's a very Viltrumite thing to do, so it makes sense that an experience like that could level up Alan onto the level of a Viltrumite. Now, just because Alan's Viltrumite level doesn't mean he's going to be beating Viltrumites, and doesn't mean Viltrumites can't beat him, but it means now we have potentially two people that legitimately can stand a chance against Viltrumites in Alan and Mark, which is, again, a start towards something. Potentially three, if we could ever free Nolan, and he could, you know, as awkward as that is, we're going to need all the help we can get. And I do expect, if Nolan doesn't get killed, which I don't think he will, I do think we're going to have to team up with him eventually, which is going to be wild. So if you think, like, then you have Nolan, you have Mark, you have Alan, and then you have Mark's little brother, his half-brother, potentially. That's four, then, people that could potentially fight Viltrumites. And I do fully expect Eve, at some point, to go full, like, goddess mode. Because there were a lot of points to the Adam Eve special. Namely, telling us, hey, this is a main character. She's really fucking important. But it also kind of opened the door to just how far her powers can go if fully unleashed. And I think, again, gives us another person who can certainly at some point be a Viltrumite slayer. So that would give us five, right? So if we consider Mark, Eve, Nolan, Alan, and fucking Mark's little brother. So like, you know, you start to count them up, and then it's like maybe Immortal could be, you know, put up a little bit of a fight. We know he's put up fights before against Omni-Man, but again, unsuccessfully. You start to piece together some level of resistance, but in the grand scheme of things, it's like, how are we going to beat a fuck ton? If Viltrum sends, like, the full brunt of their power, like, what the fuck are we supposed to do? Even with all of that finagling, I still don't see how we stand any fucking chance outside of internal strife and discord. That's the only way I think we could possibly win this, is if we could, you know, spark some sort of chain reaction that leads to Viltrum turning on itself, which I don't necessarily think is where we're going. So I'm really fucking curious where we actually are going. But yeah, a lot of fun stuff that I've been thinking about. I feel like it was worth talking about all that, because this is episode 6, and I don't think Viltrum is going to come up this episode, but I am expecting Viltrum stuff in episode 7 and 8. It could. It certainly could. I wouldn't be surprised maybe if, like, an end credit scene this episode teases the stuff to come. Because I think 7 and 8 are going to be focused a lot on whatever the fuck's going to happen with Viltrum. You know, Mark, who, you know, was kind of, who basically was recruited into the Viltrum army without his consent. And, you know, they're basically like, hey, you better do what we tell you, or you're gonna regret it, and Earth's gonna regret it. It's better for them if you just, basically the shit that Nolan was spewing to Mark, but now instead of a father that's telling him, it's just a military alien guy. But anyways, fun stuff, a lot of just jumbled random thoughts, but I figure with these episodes, it's good to get a lot of stuff out, so I hopefully don't need to pause unless something crazy happens, so I can get it through in one flow. So anyways, let's check out episode 6 of Invincible Season 2. I actually don't know the title yet. Give me one second. It's not that simple. All right. It's not that simple. That could be referring to a lot of things, to be honest. All right, let's check out season 2, episode 6 of Invincible. It's not that simple. In 3, 2, 1, and play. All right, we got another longer episode. I think the last two episodes have been the two longest episodes. I think they've been longer than any of the season 2, part 1. One. Yep.
He is the key.
Yep, that's a transition to this episode. Like, I know...
I'm kind of still screwed up about what happened.
Oh, interesting. I didn't even know that's going to come up. Alive.
Now he's left another planet in ruins, and his new kid is sitting in my kitchen.
They possess the real Russ Livingston. And
yeah, we still haven't finished the sequence storyline. So I assume when we resolve the sequence thing, it's going to immediately transition to Alan looking for him. And yet the books are important. The man with the invincible gun is Jesus Christ. Bro really likes eating human flesh, by the way. Yep, and that's where we left off with the... Okay, we're going straight to Rex.
So brave. But is it the brave man who survives?
Is it going to be some sleight of hand thing that's going to, like, get him a...
Until his opponent
get him a little, like, to explosion fight. To fuck him up and then he's going to beat him? Just or is someone going to save him? Prick. Holy shit! I don't know. Was that a lethal blow? That looks pretty fucking lethal.
Guardians! Protect!
What the fuck? I literally spent... I'm suspicious that he might survive. Like, I know that was a headshot, but I've seen way worse in this show. I mean, this is kind of like a pointless. Like, what are you... I mean, Rudy's got to focus.
Almost done. Whatever you are planning, it will fail.
Jesus. Damn, immortal.
You could have been useful servants. We will grant you death instead.
Damn.
There's too many of them.
Damn.
We can't give up.
I mean, all you can do is, like, just protect Rudy and hope his shit works.
I'm not as strong as Eve, but I can keep them away for a few minutes.
A few minutes is all I need.
It tickles.
Yeah, because they don't really, like, they can't really do much with the Martians. Oh, bro, you're about to get tentacled.
Shapesmith?
Please, hurry!
Hurry?
Done. Tell them someone has to get this close to Russ and then press the button.
Yep. Yep.
Please, hurry.
Invincible, come on.
Anyone.
Mark. Or Immortal, that works too. What the fuck, Mark?
How dare you?
Holy shit, Mark.
Stop it. I'm stronger and faster than you, and you know it. Don't fail.
Yeah.
Cover me.
Hey, he kind of has, like, obviously Immortal's got, like, a weird relationship with Mark because of what happened with Nolan. It makes sense. Holy shit. Oh my god. Well, I mean, that bought you a couple seconds. Yeah, you don't want them anywhere near Rudy. Oh, fuck. You better get there, Mark. Jesus Christ. Animation's really good, too. Like, not like peak or anything, but like... I think Invincible Season 2 has had better animation than Season 1. I've talked about this. There you go! That should be close enough. Holy fuck.
Got you! Yes! Hell yes! We did it!
Did you?
Oh, fuck!
We were too powerful.
Oh, fuck.
Maybe there's some juice left in this thing?
That's a big maybe.
Yeah, and you don't have Rudy to help now. Yeah, but all the other ones are, like, turned off temporarily. So it did fry. That's enough. That's enough. Holy shit. Just okay? Enough.
Yeah.
That's probably an experience.
Just happy to be me again.
Yep.
Yes, hooray! 10 out of 10. We need to go now.
What are you gonna do? Blow the ship up? Did you bear a self-destruct?
I'll explain later.
You don't want to fucking know.
Oh,
Jesus Christ!
The Guardians are dead. They're so dead. They've made quite the mess of your precious little missile base. I'm not sure you'll ever get the floors clean again. Agree to my demands, and I will consider not destroying half of the nation.
He's still fucking alive. Holy fuck, Rex!
Well, look at this brave little soldier. Seems
what
like
the fuck, Rex?
Your brain hasn't hurt you as much as one would expect.
That's ironic for Rex.
How sad.
King Lizard, you're about to fucking die, you idiot.
I said, shut up!
Yeah, you fucking idiot. Yeah, you idiot. God, he's such a dumbass. He might be smart. The smartest ones are always the stupidest ones. Holy fuck. Yeah, you might as well kill him. I don't even blame you. Jesus Christ. Dude, Jesus Christ, Rex.
Are you alright?
Bro.
Why would you... That's a weird question. I'm fine. Totally good. Huh? Never better?
Bro is so loopy right now.
You know
the blood loss has fucking him up.
Practically...
Yes! Yes! Episode. Yep. Daddy falls down. So they're gonna save him.
Oh, now.
Yep.
Get a stretcher over here.
Christ, Rex got fucked up. What the fuck? What the fuck? No way, Ray?
Jesus.
Oh my God, Ray! Yes! Yes! My girl's alive! What the fuck? Oh, okay, so they just killed Kate. I mean, that's still crazy, but...
Halt! You saved us from the Sequoids, and for that we are grateful.
Yeah, you're welcome. Look, we gotta go.
But we cannot permit you to leave with the Great Betrayer.
Oh.
Me?
Yeah.
This is all you're doing. You must remain here for punishment.
What kind of punishment?
Death.
That makes sense.
I understand.
Yo, they just fucking broke out. Oh my God, oh my God, it actually is Star Wars now. What the fuck? Not Star Trek, but close enough.
Fires back.
I don't know. I've only been inside one of these ones when I was a kid. It was a school trip.
Wow. So... Oh, bro's just gonna go outside and fuck up the ships itself. Honestly, that makes perfect sense for fucking Invincible. Why not? Bro! You're starting to... That's a very, like, Nolan thing to do. Very Omni-Man. Omni-Man would already be finished, but it's okay. We're getting there. Yeah, that was clean. What the fuck? God, man. Bro is cooking. Yeah, you don't even need to... Yeah, you just need to either fuck up the power or get the guy out of it. Yeah, there's, like, multiple ways that you can do this.
That was amazing!
Thanks.
Damn.
Yeah, well...
They're so gonna fuck eventually.
I trained with the best.
I... Good work.
Aw.
Thanks. You too.
Yeah, you two are two of the best.
You okay?
So.
You seem a little shook.
I mean, you did get mind fucked.
It was unpleasant having my mind under Sequid control, and being out of my armor was extremely stressful.
No shit, that whole thing was insane.
Thankfully, I was able to control my fear response this time. I changed myself. Fixed the problem.
That's one way to put it. I can
do the same for
you. Don't.
But it just makes sense to...
I said don't.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to...
You're pushing too hard, Rudy.
All right.
If she approaches you with it, that's fine.
Do this without you peeing on me again. Thank you for the update, Cecil. I'm glad Mark and the others are safe. But let's be honest. That's not the only reason you're here.
The GDA has an entire department dedicated to superhero children.
Right. Because a top secret government lab is the perfect place to raise a child.
That's true.
We paint clouds on the ceiling.
That's funny.
After everything Nolan put you through, no one expects you to raise this kid. Let us help.
Mama!
Oh, sweetie. Your mom this is far, far away.
So fucked up. It's far, far away. It's far, far away.
The truth is, Cecil, this isn't about Nolan or me.
It's about Mark.
It's about Mark.
Yep.
This child is Mark's brother.
Mm-hmm.
His only brother, which makes him family to me, too.
Debbie.
And let me remind you that I raised Mark, who just saved the world. Again, I'm more than qualified to do this.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
You raised Mark really well.
All right.
Honestly.
You win.
That's facts. Like, Cecil, like,
but we're
one.
Here if you need us.
Yeah.
And
like,
I expect to be kept in the loop.
The thing with Cecil, right? And I ended up pausing anyways. The thing with Cecil is, like, he plays this fine balance of ulterior motive and genuine. But he's genuine. Like, everything he's saying, he means it. And he's trying to help her. Like, yes, there's ulterior motive laced in it, but he's trying to be a good guy, right? And, like, the balance of that is what makes Cecil such a cool character. He's one of the best characters in this show.
It's nap time.
He's a very, like, he feels like a character from,
welcome
like,
back,
Vince
Captain
Gilligan
Livingston.
Character, like...
Can
Breaking Bad
home?
Or something, or
I just want to go home.
Or a show like that. He's really complex.
They never let me sleep.
Jesus.
I'm gonna need an entire box of Q-tips to get all that Sequid slime out of my ears.
Yeah, well, you're lucky you only got some in your ears.
Arnold. Another guy who's like fucked up.
Uh-oh.
I've seen you in the
world. Oh, yeah, because of what happened. Yeah, Kate's gone. And these two were fucking, yeah, oh my god. Oh my god, all the different bodies, that's wild. I didn't even think about that.
My...
Jesus Christ. Man, at least you're living.
And it never was that way. Something changed inside.
Yeah, but of course she's focused. Yeah.
I'm unsure of everything.
You've had your ups and downs with him, to say the least, but nobody deserves to go through the shit that those three went through. Well, maybe not no one, but certainly not those three. Oh, that was a sick transition. Oh my god, did he break up with her? Oh, he told her what happened. Oh, I think, yeah. That's too strong of a hug. Yeah. Wild. For a second,
good job.
My instinct was I want to keep her away. Oh, we're calling him Oliver, huh?
Bra-bra.
Bra-bra, huh?
Bra-bra.
We're going with Oliver,
you
huh?
Name him after Grandpa?
Well, he needed an actual name, besides Nolan's alien baby.
It's good.
MNO, Mark like Nolan it. Oliver. It's almost like they're going to team up eventually. The storm is coming, and of course, another fucking funeral. Season one flashbacks.
Kate Chaw was a fearless warrior. Though her powers came from a family curse, she believed they were a gift to help those around her.
Mm-hmm.
That was Kate's.
It's gotta be
real
so hard
power.
For Immortal because he's seen so many people die.
Her unwavering
his life.
Belief that this world is good. Even when it killed her over and over and over again. Kate never stopped believing that. And encouraged me to do the same.
Aww.
Kate Cha was a kindred soul.
Aww. Yeah, they do have an interesting, like I said, it's kind of, like, it's definitely weird that they were fucking, but it makes sense how they bonded.
It was a beautiful service.
Damn. They look good
I'm
in suits,
I'm glad it didn't rain. Kate hated the rain.
Damn.
Why do I feel this way, Marcus? Because you loved a man.
Yeah?
I loved many others before Kate. All of them died as well. But this is different.
You had, like, a connection with her that was a little deeper. And, yeah, it was sudden, right? Like, she was young. She was a superhero, so there's always that risk. But you didn't assume it would happen. Bro, I really thought he hit her with the, like, it's too dangerous for me to be your boyfriend type beat.
How's your mom? Classes.
Sorry, you go.
No, you go. Please.
Oh my god, this is so awkward.
So, classes are going okay?
I mean, I'm at the point where I just roll out of bed and go to lectures in my pajamas. It's very freeing.
This is very college vibes, yeah?
Well, how's your new brother? Is he adjusting? Is your mom losing her mind yet?
Oliver's doing great, and they really get along, which is awesome. My mom's still getting used to chewing his food for him, though.
It's a bug thing? She chews his food?
Yeah. It turns out Thraxan babies don't have enzymes to break down solid food. We're hoping his Viltrumite half will kick in soon.
Oh.
That is weird.
Okay, can I just say this feels like a first date?
Yeah, a bad first date.
Yeah, I know, right?
I missed you.
I missed you too.
It's the hard part of the job. It's something that we know Debbie has to go through.
I really thought college would be different. Right? You know, like late night study sessions, secret dorm parties, spending time with my girlfriend.
I haven't been doing any of those things.
Instead, we hang out less than we did before we went to college.
Whenever my friends here ask where you are, I'm always like, oh, Mark's studying for an exam, or he went home for the weekend. I hate lying to them, Mark. And I have no one to talk to about it. I mean, sure, there's William, but he's more your friend than mine.
Yeah, and Eve's not around. Yeah,
it's our first year of college, our first time living on our own, and it feels like we're missing it.
I like her hair.
You know, sometimes I wish I never got powers. Then I could just be with you. And forget about everything else.
But you do have powers.
Yeah.
And that means you have an obligation responsibility. To make the world a
better place. Great power, great responsibility.
If you didn't feel that way, we wouldn't be dating to begin with.
So
it's your heart.
What do we do now?
That's the thing. You make the best of the time you have together. It's all you can do. It's a theme, because that was the Kate Immortal thing as well. Hey,
Mark,
Donald.
Look who's back!
Whoa, Rick, how are you feeling?
Hi, Mark. I guess I'm fine.
It's the same thing
as
Donald,
great.
Isn't it?
Doctors gave him a clean bill of health. Donald says he can come back to upstate, right?
I'm here to help facilitate his transition. If there's anything I can do, just...
Yeah, Donald relates.
That
yep.
is so kind. Thank you.
It's definitely
on,
the
Rick.
Same tech.
I guilted the college into giving you a private room in the dorm next door. I already decorated it.
Nice.
Wow, Rick looks exactly the same. It's like nothing happened.
Something did happen. He went through intensive body reconstruction. That kind of trauma can...
Yeah.
Resurface.
Yeah. But
are you okay?
No. No.
Tell William I'll check in later to see how Rick's doing.
Dude, Donald, you need to talk to someone.
Bye.
Jesus Christ, Donald. I don't know who you can talk to, well, though, because you bro's like always watching.
Shit. And that's coming from a guy that looks like this.
Fucking hell.
Heard you're getting a new hand, too.
Yeah. Lucky me.
Damn,
how's
bro.
Ray?
Hold it in there.
You know, when that bullet went through my head, I saw my life flash before my eyes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not the greatest
life.
That's
always sounded like bullshit to me, too, but...
It happens. It really happens. That's what people say.
I didn't like what I saw.
It's a phenomenon that apparently happens.
Such a dick to Kate.
And
to Eve.
Eve,
too.
Yeah.
Every woman I've ever dated.
Guys, too, but I get your
None
point.
None of them deserved
yes, the
it.
The dating potatoes.
I don't know why.
This is what
I
I'm talking about,
my
though.
Brain's
the character
blown
development.
Out to see that.
Yeah.
What is it about being a superhero where we go around saving lives while ruining them at the same time?
Yep.
Jesus. All right, let's hear it.
Yeah, it's like, fuck, what? I nearly died. But
the reason your face looks all...
blah.
Like that.
Yeah.
I don't know, you know, sad and shit.
Yeah. God, his voice acting's so good here, Rex. You can hear everything he's been through in his voice. Voice acting in the show is... fantastic.
Mark!
Oh, hey, Eve. You here to see Rex?
Yeah, I try to stop in when I can. Oh, these, turns out Rex really likes home decorating magazines. I think it's because he's never really had a home. Hey, I haven't seen you since Kate's funeral. Are you okay, Mark?
Yeah. No, I'm... fine. Anyway, I gotta run, so I'll see you around.
I don't think anyone's okay. Like, I think that's kind of the theme. You actually seem like you're doing pretty well, Eve.
Eve! The bearer of spring colors and waterfall countertops.
You're the only person I know who still reads magazines.
Honestly.
Oh, I'm cultured like that. And plus, the internet sucks.
Fair enough.
So
the internet's the best and worst thing.
Mark and...
ugh, I know, right? He and Amber are...
wait, what does that mean?
Oh, 10 best bedroom makeovers?
What the fuck? That distraction.
Yeah,
yo! Dude, no, so, Eve! Dude! Helga, dude, why is this happening? Dude, Eve is gonna totally, like... dude, Eve and Mark are totally gonna fuck soon. Dude, it's just the energy, man. Dude, Eve has wanted Mark for a lot, like, ever since, like, there was the moment in season one where she was like, ooh, and then she saw that, you know, Mark and Amber were making out, and she was like, good for you, Mark, or whatever. Oh, man, this is so weird. The interpersonal relationships of the show are, there's something.
For 30 years, children are my life.
You
Your resume is
sound
very
like you sound
yes.
like the same.
But I don't think you're the right fit for us. No, no.
You sound like the
I'm
same voice actress.
Spy? I don't understand. I was married to Nolan for 20 years. I can spot Cecil's people a mile away. So thank you. Bye bye. That man cannot take a hint.
Hi. I'm April Housam, here for the nanny position. Now, before we begin, you should know that Cecil sent me. Now, I wasn't supposed to tell you, but I think it's unacceptable to mislead a potential employer, especially one looking for someone to take care of their child.
All right, let's talk.
Please come in.
As you can see, I have extensive experience working with gifted children ranging from newborns to late teens.
So you know that Oliver is...
half Thraxen, half Viltrumite. I also know that Nolan Grayson, or Omni-Man, is Oliver's father, and that your son Mark, also Invincible, is Oliver's half-brother.
You've been thoroughly briefed, I see.
My philosophy on child-rearing is simple. Encourage a child's natural curiosity for the world. Here you go, buddy. While giving him structure and a safe space to grow and learn.
Yeah, that is the goal.
I also play a mean lullaby on the ukulele.
Aww.
I appreciate your honesty, April. But I don't want a GDA agent in my house running interference for Cecil on how to raise Oliver.
There's only a handful of people in the world with my skill set. This allows me job security and freedom from government oversight. I work for you, Miss Grayson, not Cecil. Period.
Interesting.
You're the boss, not him.
Interesting.
I'm a boss.
See? Oliver knows who's in charge.
Mama boss.
What is up with this episode? There was a weird energy in that scene, too. I must be imagining things.
Real
now.
Real nice place you made here, Eve.
Cecil.
I like her, though.
Reminds
April.
Me of where I grew up.
Really?
I wanted to thank you personally for helping out with the whole Sequid business. And to once again offer you a spot on the Guardians.
Cecil.
Duplicate's dead. Ray and Rex are in the hospital, and Immortal is... Well, let's be frank, his head is not in the game right now.
Sure.
So what do you say? Ready to join the team?
He really does need everyone he can get.
Anyway.
Cecil. You know, I'm still figuring out what kind of hero I want to be, and that's not the kind of person you need on the Guardians. But you know how to find me if you need my help again.
And you know where to find me when you change your mind.
I love Cecil. God, he's so good. He's kind of like the glue that keeps this whole series together.
You up there?
Oh, it's Amber. Hi.
Amber? Your place really blends in with the trees. I walked past it like 5 times. Can we talk?
Okay, so he was, Mark was talking with Rex, and now Amber's gonna talk with Eve. I'm here for it. Who are you about to talk to? Debbie? Who's gonna walk in?
I told you it's gonna be another 4 hours. You want it done fast or done right?
Hey, Art.
Mark! Sorry, I thought you were someone else. Just leave your suit and I'll have it fixed by morning.
I actually came to talk, but if you're busy, I can...
What's on your mind?
Well,
Ah, I see. Girl trouble.
That obvious.
Oh, he's gonna talk to his tailor.
Pull up a chair.
They're not gonna have beers, but it's basically the...
And I love Amber, and I want to be with her, but...
God, they're really setting us up so hard.
Conspiring against us.
Ugh, it doesn't matter if you're a superhero or an ordinary Joe.
It always feels like that. Yeah.
I should know. I've been in plenty of them in my day.
I bet.
I've only dated one guy. Rex was my first serious boyfriend, which is sad and embarrassing to admit out loud. We all got to start somewhere. You know, we'd known each other for years. It just kind of made sense. And it was good for a while.
And then he decided to fuck it up.
Until I finally had enough of him cheating on me every time he left the tower.
Jesus Christ! How many times did he cheat on you?
That hurt more.
I think we knew twice,
but... He made me feel like I was crazy when I started figuring it out. That really sucked.
Yeah, the lying was the worst part for me, too. But I thought after we
there's levels to it though. Like, let's not compare Rex cheating to Mark
being trying to hide his identity.
Guts to not care what anyone else thinks, you know? Never always does the right thing. It's inspiring.
The cuts in this episode
makes me a better person.
A real catch. So what's the problem?
The problem is
me, my life.
Invincible. Whether it's a tsunami or some psycho with rocket launchers for arms, when bad things happen, Mark has to drop everything and go. Yeah.
And that's the life.
Everything.
Mm-hmm.
Including you.
Yep.
I don't care when Mark cancels our date or forgets to text. I mean, he's saving the world. It's not that. It's that it makes me feel like a...
jerk.
Yeah.
Because I'm doing exactly what my dad did to me and my mom.
Yep.
But
that's the
never
job.
Because
right?
A, it made us feel like
you
assholes,
can't.
And B, we didn't want to distract him.
Oh, that's so
world.
Wild, too, because he's relating it to his father. Oh, there's so many layers to this. It's so good.
I don't want that kind of life for Amber. She deserves better.
Well, If you guys can't always be together, then make the times you are together count.
That doesn't work either. When we're together, I feel guilty. Like I'm taking him away.
They're from really about to break up.
Need him.
Wow.
Mark needs someone who
is there for her. Who really understands what she's going through in college and
what it's like dating a superhero. I can't talk to anyone about it. Not my friends, not my family. So now I'm the liar instead of him.
Damn.
I knew dating Mark would be difficult. I just didn't know it would be so lonely.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm failing Mark.
Aww, that's
so
cute.
You're not saving the world right now.
And Mark's back on Earth, so I guess the question you have to ask yourself is,
why are you talking to me?
When
yes.
You should be talking to him.
Yes.
Go home, Mark.
Oh my
Go
God.
Home and be with your girlfriend.
This scene is amazing.
Yeah. Thanks for listening, Art.
Oh my God.
Hey, your mom told me what happened with your dad on Thraxa. That had to be tough.
What? It's so what
Seeing
the fuck
him again.
Everything.
Even
about
after everything
it was
he
tough.
Did.
Still
I didn't
my dad.
Realize how much I missed him.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe that makes me a bad person or something.
Not at all.
It makes you human.
Yes.
And then the last thing he told me before the Viltrumites
okay,
took
that
him
was
away
a little weird.
Wasn't I love you or
it was read
I'm
my
sorry.
Fucking books.
It was read my books.
Why did he say that?
I don't know. My mom threw out all his stuff when I was away. I got his travel books from the library, but nothing popped out.
Nolan wrote more than just travel books.
What?
He wrote sci-fi novels under a pen name when you were a kid. None of them sold great, so he gave it up.
Interesting.
He gave them to me as a tip once. A big spender, your dad was not.
Lost inside the chasm to oblivion.
Interesting.
Hate tribes on the planet Wreck.
I told Nolan they were great. Real exciting. I never read them.
After the
these are either real
destroyed,
stories
they just rebuilt it exactly
or something.
The same. A missed opportunity, if you ask me.
With these.
I don't remember this.
Yeah.
Commemorates D.A.
Just
Sinclair's
like how Donald didn't remember the
victims.
Victims?
You're the only one who recovered. Hungry? They did upgrade the waffle maker in the cafeteria.
I see flashes sometimes. Sinclair's face, a scalpel.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like I'm watching someone else's nightmare.
It's like watching a movie.
Am I me again, William?
What? Of course you're you.
D.A. Sinclair took so much of me away. I don't think they found it all. Who am I if I can't even remember what I'm missing?
Damn.
Rick, I'm so sorry. It's going to be all right. I promise. We'll get through this.
That's such an interesting
together.
Concept to explore, too. That's a cool thing about Invincible. There's all these, like, different things going on that it can explore all these different
Man
really
the
interesting
Invincible
topic.
Gun.
Yep.
Catchy title, Dan.
Invincible.
Little was known about the space rider. He was a mystery. The stuff of legends. Stories about him
stretched across the 12 galaxies. But in all of them, one detail remained constant.
Yeah,
the
Invincible
Infinity Ray.
Infinity Ray.
It was said to emit an unstoppable energy wave that destroyed anything in its path. But it required a steady hand. And more importantly, a steady mind.
You have to know when to use it, when not to use it.
It wasn't a weapon to be used in haste.
Yep. The power in a weapon is
no
to know when to use it, when not to use it.
No one has ever gotten close enough
to
study the Infinity Ray for themselves.
So this is a real person in space?
The space rider always makes sure of that.
Holy shit. Yeah, I was gonna say, it's gonna destroy the sun, too.
If the Infinity Ray is indeed real, and as powerful as the stories claim, it poses a huge
threat to our mission. Huh. Okay.
Yep.
Savage planet, savage beasts.
Okay, these are all the ways we could maybe beat them.
Planet and report back to Space Command headquarters.
Yep.
The first thing we noticed was its gravity. The planet was so dense and its pull so strong,
sure,
we could barely move.
That makes sense. And that's impressive if fucking Viltrumites can barely move.
My partner and I were ready to return home. But the planet had other plans.
Oh my god! Poor girl.
Ragnars.
I was literally about to say she's pretty cute. Damn. Not very cute anymore, though, unfortunately. Damn!
In an instant, I was surrounded, swarmed, overwhelmed. I've battled creatures 10 times their size.
But the movement, right? The gravity, yep.
Ragnars had evolved strength like no other.
Interesting. So these are all the ways that you could maybe beat a Viltrumite. The Infinity Ray, the Ragnars.
I underestimated these creatures, and I feared this place would be
my grave. Wait. No way.
That's what all these books are. All the times he almost died, or all the stories of
what do you want, Cecil?
Ways to kill Viltrumites.
Bermuda.
Interesting.
I hear it's lovely this time of year.
What are you talking about?
You and a long overdue vacation on the house.
No.
No.
I wasn't asking.
Damn, bro, you're suspending his ass?
How dare you?
Sykes concerned, so am I. And since you refuse to see our specialist...
I don't need your pinheads poking around my brain!
Kate's death was difficult for everyone. But I need you...
I said I'm fine!
No, you're not.
What? Send it here.
What is that?
Someone's coming in hot from deep space.
Omni-Man.
He just immediately assumes it's Omni-Man! Yes.
Donald.
Yes! I had a feeling it was Alan.
Ugh, where did Invincible say he lived again? Crap, this is gonna be tricky. Well, hey, I think there's been a misunderstanding. How can I hear you speak? Okay, it's just this implant I have. It lets us communicate telepathically. It's not a big deal. Get out of my head! I am not here to fight. I'm just looking for Invincible. Invincible! Omni-Man sent you!
No.
Chill the hell out. I do not want to hurt you, sir.
Damn, the poke in the eye, the ultimate weakness.
Oh, you cross the line with that one. I'll kill you! We just met!
He's so
Invincible.
Good.
What the hell is going on?
I don't know. I came here looking for you, and then suddenly this douchebag attacked me. You have those on Earth, right? Douchebags?
Yes.
Alan's my friend. He's a good guy.
My thing only works between me and someone else, not between two other someone else's. It's a design flaw. I'm told there's an update coming.
Right. Can you tell him?
Yeah, with pleasure. Hi, sir. Mark says I'm a pal. He also says I'm essentially the king of space, so you should be very nice to me. Also, he says he hates your dumb beard because it's missing all the best parts of a beard.
Wow.
These parts.
Wow.
I don't believe you. He doesn't believe me.
Did Alan attack you or threaten you?
Oh, good question. Mark wants to know if I attacked you or threatened you, which I totally didn't, because you just charged up here and attacked me. Not very heroic of you, Earth superhero of Earth.
Earth superhero of Earth.
I thought you were someone else.
Damn, he was ready to throw hands with Omni-Man.
His girlfriend just died.
Well, now I feel like a giant douchebag. You do have them, right?
Yes.
You keep making that reference?
Yes, yes, we understand that reference.
Can we go somewhere that's not, like, in space? And also, for future reference, will you just point to where you live?
What the fuck? The fucking, I forget the word, Oh my god, what's that called? Photobomb. God, I'm so old. Is she about to... They showed the guy that she's kind of friendly with. Damn. Spend that money, I ain't charging you. But I ain't splitting nothing with supply. You have some fun, girl. Cause I cut the mean of star. Oh, God.
Right, we should be good now.
You know, on my planet, a sock on the door means somebody's fucking.
Yeah, it's the same here.
God damn it.
Oop, sorry.
You're a lot bigger than the last time I saw you.
Apparently that's what happens when you almost get murdered by a bunch of Ultramites, and you're me. But, get this. My boss, Thetis, is also a Viltrumite.
What?
I know, right? It turns out he rebelled against the Empire, like, years ago. So, that makes two of you. It's not much, but it is a start. Now, we could only win over your dad.
Yeah, about my dad.
Yeah, he's about to get executed.
And they took him away. Said they're gonna execute him, if they haven't already.
That is, wow.
Yeah.
That is quite the story.
Yeah.
Do you think my dad's dead?
I don't know. Viltrumites are weird about killing their own people. I think because it doesn't happen much anymore.
Mm. So, why are you here exactly?
Oh, yes, right, of course. On behalf of Thetis and the Coalition of Planets, I am to escort you to Telescria to discuss our war against the Viltrum Empire and how you can help. Grab your stuff, Mark. We got a boogie.
What? No. I just got back from space.
Yeah, he's sick of going to space.
I'm not going back just to talk to your boss.
This could be our chance to infiltrate your team for good. Isn't that what you want?
Of course. But Amber and I are in a weird place. And now that my mom's looking after my half-brother, I can't just ditch her. Are we going to have to fight now?
Nah, I don't fight friends. Because I would win, and then I feel terrible. It's a vicious cycle.
Love it.
I should get going. Thetis will not be happy with me.
God, Seth Rogen really is the perfect voice for him. It's wild.
I have a hunch about something, but I need a second opinion.
Huh. This place sounds kind of familiar. Hey! Is that Space Racer?
Yep.
But it's Space Rider in the book.
It's Space Racer in real life, and he is legendary in that no one is sure if he's real or not.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think everything in these books is real. And it's all stuff that can hurt Viltrumites. That's why my dad wanted me to read his books. He's telling us how to defeat the Empire.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Can I scan these to take back to the Coalition?
Of course.
Thetis will be a lot less pissed when I show him all of this.
Yeah. Oh, that's cool. You get the full contents of the books. That's awesome.
All right, got it. It was good seeing you again, Mark. Thank you.
Yep.
And I'm very sorry about your father's impending or already completed
execution. Impending or already completed execution. Yeah, what a fucking
lie. I still don't
get
why they took him away when they could have just killed him on Thraxa.
I've heard rumors of a Viltrumite prison somewhere in space. Maybe they took him there. Want me to ask around?
Interesting.
I'd appreciate that.
Viltrumite prison. Who would they even imprison? Like other... unless there actually are other Viltrumites that
have
betrayed them.
We need someone for the actual fight.
And they just kept that hidden.
I'll be there.
Of course.
Count on it.
Hell yeah. That's season 3, though, if I had to guess.
Hey, Mark. Are you and Amber done yet? That sock's been on the door for hours, and I really need to go to bed.
Wow. Yeah, we're not actually fucking. It was ironically a lot more important.
In order
than that.
For a Viltrumite to be executed,
is this the prison?
He must be healed and whole, worthy to stand and face the end of his life with honor. Even if his crime was devoid of it, yet for even such a craven betrayal, there is a path to redemption. Rejoin your people, Nolan. Let this not be your legacy.
What are you gonna say, Nolan? Nothing.
You conquered hundreds of planets, brought glory to the Empire. You were one of our greatest warriors. How did a mere moment on Earth turn you into a weak, sentimental traitor?
He woke up. Oh my God.
Answer me!
Fuck you. don't need to answer you. Dude, he's just biding his time.
The planet and its people are toxic if they could do this to you. They too will pay.
Oh shit, that's not good. And that's the setup for episode 7. They're about to go to the credits. Yeah, yeah, he's holding back so hard. Oh no, I thought that was going to be the credits, and then we'd get an end credit scene.
It wasn't enough that you left me to die on Mars. You had to trash my place, too.
Wow. Ew. Honestly, Fax. That's pretty fucking disgusting. Oh no. Oh no, what the fuck's inside of him? Oh, just puke, okay. Oh no. Oh no, please do not tell me that's like some weird sequid thing. Oh fuck! Oh Jesus Christ. Oh Jesus Christ. It like laid an egg or something inside of him and he puked it up? Oh fuck. Well, I wasn't expecting that. I guess it makes sense that that wouldn't get resolved that easily.
Let me help you with the jacket.
A big thing they were building up.
Mm, an excellent fit, if I do say so myself. May I ask, sir, what's the occasion for
Titan?
Such a fine suit?
Oh, no.
I'm visiting an old friend.
Oh, fuck, Anstrom. Oh, God. Okay. Okay. Oh, they're about to cook. Nice fucking zombie apocalypse world. Dude, what a fucking cool fucking...
It is good to be home.
Oh, I bet it is. Oh boy. Oh boy, let's fucking get it, baby. Yeah, we're good. Alright. Woo! Okay. That was episode 6 of Invincible Season 2. And that was pretty awesome. Great episode. A bit of a cooldown from last episode. We did get the conclusion to the Sequid situation, although it turns out that wasn't actually the end. The thing that we were so afraid of actually still ended up happening in the end, which is really cool. And I'm excited to see kind of where that goes, because it was only one Sequid, but I assume that they reproduce really fast and this is going to become a giant problem. And it's wild how all of these giant problems are building up at the same time. You have Angstrom, who we haven't seen in a little while. You have all the stuff. Like, there's just so much stuff building right now, and it's so interesting to kind of see all of that come together at the same time. Like, I'm really excited to see the Angstrom stuff develop. I'm excited to see the Sequid stuff, which we are continuing. I'm excited to see, obviously, of course, how the Viltrumite stuff comes into play. And like, but there's just a lot of different avenues that they could explore in these final two episodes. It's pretty wide open on how this is all going to go down and where they're going to end this second season of Invincible. I think this season has been, I think, more like Invincible Season 1. The Nolan Debbie stuff was so good throughout, right? I think that was such an interesting driver in the story. I think the overall show is better now. Like, obviously, we don't have that, like, intriguing kind of mystery element that we had in Season 1 that was the best part of Season 1. And obviously, like, the final two episodes or so were just insane. But I do feel like Season 2, like, as an overall world and just collective universe, like, just the overall, like, all the different stuff going on, I've enjoyed Season 2, I think, a fair bit more than Season 1, but I don't think Season 2 has that, like, one thing that just has me, like, so locked in, right? So I think Season 2 is a lot overall, like, a lot more interesting, but I don't think it has that one narrative that's just so perfect. So it's a little bit of a different of experience, but I do like the way that the show has kind of expanded and over and evolved. It feels like we're watching like a superhero universe, right? Like, obviously the story is centered around Mark, but it feels like there's a universe with all these different things happening at the same time, and the way the show portrays that I think is really cool. And one of the things I really love about Invincible and the way the story has developed, because I don't necessarily, I think this is something that's kind of evolved out of season one and has been fully expanded upon and fully realized in season two, right? And it was a process to get to that point, but now we've had enough content from this series that it really feels like an expanded universe that's really interesting and has a lot of different things going on simultaneously and can tell stories in that manner. I think that's one of the things that makes Invincible really cool and a really fun watch. And I'm super excited to see what these final two episodes look like, because you know some crazy shit's going to go down. I'm starting to think less and less about my theory. I'm starting to think, if anything, we might get the huge cliffhanger. We didn't really get a huge cliffhanger at the end of season one. But, of course, this whole time, not only season two, but season three has also been confirmed. So I wouldn't be surprised if maybe season two is the one that's going to end on a massive cliffhanger, especially because I heard that apparently, you know, part of the kind of slow release schedule and everything is to kind of, among other things, is to minimize the wait time for new content. So I definitely think that when we get, I'm fully expecting season three of Invincible to be in 2025. And I think that'll be really cool. And I'm really excited for Invincible season three. With only two episodes left, I feel like we could start talking about that. I feel like, you know, some of the things we've been building up, we're going to get, like, resolutions to. But obviously the Viltrum stuff is not going to come to an overall resolution this season. And I would have to imagine that, you know, maybe the Sequid stuff gets resolved. Maybe the Angstrom stuff. I'm not so sure about that one. I could see that coming to a resolution, but obviously the overall Viltrumite story, which is kind of the main overarching story in Invincible, is, not being finished until, at the earliest, season three, and that's only if season three is the last season, which I have no idea. I assume these comics are quite long. I would have to guess that if they get more time, that they're gonna go beyond season three. Of course, like I said, when you see the episode count, you think, oh, the series is not that long. But when you consider, again, the episode lengths, we've actually had what'll soon be 16 episodes, but they're basically like double, so it's closer to like 32 episodes of Invincible, really. It's quite a bit of content, honestly. We've actually had quite a bit of content in the Invincible show. And you consider that we have another 8 episodes, presumably, for season 3, which essentially will equate to about 16 episodes of a regular animated series. You're looking at 48 episodes there, and obviously the show, I would assume, is going to go longer than season 3. I am expecting that they aren't planning to wrap up the story next season, unless the comics are shorter than I'd suspect. And, you know, this kind of adaptation's only going to go that far. But I'm assuming that, and because there's no reason that Amazon wouldn't keep renewing Invincible. Invincible is arguably the biggest animated series on Amazon. The only reason I say arguably is Has-Been Hotel was just a massive hit. And I know at the very least, like, I think Has-Been did bigger numbers than the first season of Invincible. But I don't know compared to the second season. But that's the point, right? Like, it's top two in terms of numbers at the very least, if not number one. So the point being, this show's incredibly popular and very beloved, so there's really no reason for it not to go beyond season three. So it'd be interesting to see how far it might go. And I'd be curious if anyone kind of had, like, a general idea kind of at the pace we're going. I know things are adapted in different ways, in different orders. I know it's, like, different. But just generalizing the content of the comics, how many seasons one might think there will be of Invincible. I actually, without obviously going into spoilers, I would actually be curious if anyone in the comments wants to answer that. Not that a lot of the times I don't honestly don't read the comments for spoilers' sake, but, you know, sometimes I peek. So yeah, that would actually be pretty interesting. But I'm really excited for these last two episodes, but part of the interest is, like, there's multiple directions they could go, and I'm not really sure which way they're going to go. I feel like obviously, because they've set up the Angstrom stuff, they've set up a bunch of Viltrumite stuff, they've set up the Sequid stuff. I mean, I'd imagine the Angstrom and Sequid stuff definitely happens in the next... Well, the Angstrom stuff for sure. The Sequid stuff, actually, they could save. That actually could be something where it's like we've kind of gotten chapters of it in season one and season two, but they're going to kind of do, like, the full-blown, like, all right, I'm not sure if there was, like, a little cut there or whatever, but I'm here now to finish the discussion on... finish the discussion on episode 6 of Invincible season 2, but, yeah, I mean, yeah, there's a lot of different storylines we could focus on, but I did like this episode a lot. I like how, you know, Rex has kind of put his life into perspective with what happened. I'm happy that Rey is gonna seemingly make it. I'm really excited about that. And I'm also really looking forward to, you know, and I like how, like, Amber and Mark are really putting their relationship into perspective, and it kind of shows, like, how similar they are, that they're both thinking essentially the exact same thing, and they're even getting the same advice, and it's really, one, it's really cute, but also it both shows that, like, they can be really good for each other, while also showing why it's probably not going to work out simultaneously, which I think is really cool storytelling. And it's set up in a way where if Mark and Amber, like, their relationship works out, that would make sense. And if Mark and Amber's relationship doesn't work out, that would also make sense. I could very easily see them having an amicable separation, but I also could see them staying together. And I feel like both are very plausible based on the way that their romance has been written. I just kind of feel like, to me, it feels like Eve and Mark is just an inevitability. I have, like, it just feels like it's gonna happen. I feel like it's always felt like it's gonna happen, and the writing has been written in a way to kind of encourage that. Now, that might be part of the fake out, because it's not gonna happen, but I can't help but feel like it's gonna happen. Now, there's obviously some slightly odd things that come about that, but I'm still leaning in that direction. But, like, with Mark and Amber, I feel like if they break up, it's going to be because they mutually decide to move on and still be friends and all that good stuff, which is something I also like, that if they do separate it looks like it's going to end up being, like, a really chill separation if it does happen. That feels like something that could happen in this season, but I kind of imagine if it does happen, it's probably going to be in season 3. But yeah, there's a lot of stuff. There's a lot of different parts moving around, and I'm really excited to see how all of this plays out and what we get to in the final two episodes. Cause I mean, who knows, honestly, who knows what we're going to do, but we're so close to the end of season 2 of Invincible. Obviously it was kind of like 2 mini seasons, cause we got, you know, 4 episodes and then we had a few months off, and now we're getting the final 4 episodes, and you know, 8 episodes at a double length is a proper season. 4 episodes at double length is a bit short. You know, if you can call it a core of anime, like, I feel like, it's funny, I feel like 5 episodes at double length is, like, probably enough to be considered a proper season. Because I feel like 10 episodes of, like, an anime or a cartoon is probably the cap. Like, I feel like if it's under 10 episodes, it's not really a season. You know what I mean? I feel like that's where I'd cut it off. So I feel like for Invincible, you need 5 episodes to be, like, a proper season. You know, I think 4 just doesn't cut it. So it's kind of these weird half seasons. Obviously, 8 episode seasons of Invincible feel like a season because of how long the episodes are. But, yeah, I'm kind of wandering all over the place with this conversation, so I think I'm just going to end it off here. If you want to support the channel, Patreon's down below in the description, Discord server, all that fun stuff. Yeah, I've been, you know, I'm kind of still a little iffy on the consistency. Hopefully April will be banging out videos, but we'll see what happens. But anyways, Flamin' Shark signing out. Hope you all have a wonderful, fantastical day, and I'll see you next time with another video. Thanks for watching. Peace.